H2K Infosys provides world-class online IT training, staffing and software testing solutions to customers worldwide. H2K Infosys supports 100% job-oriented training, hands-on project work, cloud test lab, resume preparation and review, mock interviews, robust syllabus. One-time pay, lifetime access to live classes and videos. H2K Infosys has won the trust of thousands of students worldwide. For free demo class, visit h2kinfosys.com.
Good. So, what we are going to do is quickly go through whatever we learned and then we'll continue what we are going to learn today. So, we started with creating variables. Okay. We declared them, we assigned them, we print them. Right. So, let's quickly jump to the classes. This is PyCharm. We have not started using this. Okay. So we're gonna continue using our Eclipse only. So let me start that real quick. Meanwhile, we'll go through the materials and quickly check what exactly we have done. And then start for today. So we started creating variables, right? Then we check that variables are reassigned with some other values. Closing PyCharm. Then what we have done is we have understood the number types of variables, like what are the different variables we have. We know that this is an officially a first class, okay, but while introducing students to Python, okay, we have actually started with some of the initial steps which we are revising now. Hold on. Just showing everything, don't worry. Opening materials. Okay, so let's go ahead. Python is a simple language. We did this. Okay, so we got the introduction of it. Okay, so Vinita, there is an introductory video, okay, available to us. Okay, whatever sessions, introductory sessions we have done are basically recorded. Okay, so you can quickly go through it. It's just a matter of 1 hour. Okay, and we installed out of these three. Okay, actually, we installed everything, right? So we installed Python, it's unzipped it, just downloading, nothing else, then Eclipse and Eclipse plugin. Okay, we have detailed video for that, and we installed PyCharm, but we haven't used it yet. Okay, so we're gonna use it in later part when we are going to use web development in Python, right? So this is a screenshot of Eclipse Marketplace where we grabbed PyDev, okay, which we are going to use in Eclipse, right? So first thing we saw is indentation, whether Python uses indentation. Okay, so indentation is these four spaces. Python has meaning to it, so you cannot leave that. Okay, so if you leave it, you're gonna get an error. Once Eclipse starts, we can show that. We have tested it. We also saw what is the Python comment. It starts with hash. Okay, so we cannot skip indentation. This is a comment actually. Can I have please this document? Yeah, everybody has this document, don't worry. Okay, then doc string, basically, which is created to write a documentation of the class. Okay, so documentation capability can be done with the help of triple quotes. Okay, so triple quotes will give you doc strings. Okay. Then we started with variables. So we assign variables. Basically, we write a name of the variable, equal sign, and then declare the variable. No semicolon required, nothing. Okay. So you just need a a new line character or a space character basically is to assign or to complete the line. That's it. You also know that variables do not have types. Okay, they do, but they carry it internally. Okay, we don't have to declare types for the variable. Right, so name equals to John, age equals to 5 are enough things to actually declare it, then print it. So print is a function which will print the value. Okay, so print age will print 5 and print name will print John. Right, so we also saw some basic rules of variables, like how should we write variables, and variables are case sensitive. Correct, so you have these three are different variables, age, and age. There are three types of numeric variables. In Python, okay, or numeric data types, I will say, then integer, float, and complex. Complex is imaginary numbers. So integer is a positive, negative, integer things. Okay, so basically, it can hold zero, it can hold negative value, positive value, but no decimal points. Float though have decimal points in it, and you have J for indicating complex numbers. Right? So complex number are written with J. Then you can cast them, okay, so one into another. So once you declare that, what happened to my Eclipse today? You start quickly with the PyCharm, okay, so it is much faster than this. Anyway, we are casting it, so casting meaning changing into one form to another. So once you take, let's say, X, str, S1, so that means S1 will be categorized into string. If you are passing a float, let's say integer 2.8, then the integer part of it will be taken out and provided in y. So that means y value will be 2. And float 3, so if you pass a string, oh, this is string by the way. So if you pass string to a float, then float is converting that into 3.0. Okay. So if you are passing your name here and you are changing it to an integer or float, okay, so there will be an error. Okay, so it should be convertible. Good. So Python strings, so when you declare a string in Python, where is failing? Otherwise we'll restart our question. So Python strings, so string literals in Python are surrounded either by single quote marks or double quote marks, no issues with that. So you, this is also a valid string, this is also a valid string for Python. Okay, so no issues with it. So when you have declared, let's say A equals to hello world, okay, so you can actually have an index to it. So every character in string has index. So index meaning a position. So position of H is 0, E is 1, L is 2, and it goes on. Okay, even space has a position. Okay, so now you have print A1, that means you are actually print E, because position starts or index starts with 0. You can have range view, okay, so range view where you have 2:5, where 2 is inclusive and 5 is exclusive, so you will get the characters from here to here, right? Then you have strip function to remove the additional spaces appended before and after, okay, not in between, so this space will not be removed. Then length of the string, like how many character it holds. Then lower, it converts into lowercase, upper converts into uppercase, replaces, like you, if you want to replace something with something else, you can do that, and your split functions, okay, whether you want to change into two different arrays or two different strings, okay, so if you want to do that, then there is a separator, okay, and then you can use it as a different string, okay. So Python allows command line input also, that we saw. So basically enter your name and then you have X equals to input, where you can actually grab this input from where your keyboard, right? So you're going to grab that and you're going to use that, right? So we tested this print hello and used it. So this is our project. So learning, parsing, okay, so we have parsing, we tested this, okay, we have Python string, test input, and variables. All these things, all these classes are available in your class code folder, okay, so you can grab it from there. New people, you're gonna get access from H2K Infosys, so you have to write to them. Fine, not a problem. List we're gonna consider. Okay, so list is different story. Okay, so okay, there is a question and there is an answer to it by Sitara, and really good that you are exploring yourself. Okay, so I'm thankful for it. So basically we're gonna use this list functions, okay, list tuples and everything. Okay, so we'll do it. Okay, we're gonna learn them. Nice. So up to this point, we have learned up to this point, right? Okay, this is the point we left our day one. So yes, command line input, like that is day one. So day two, we're gonna start with operators, right? So what is operators? Here and Python operators basically, and it divides into a lot of groups. Out of that, all of them are not important for us, but what are the important stuffs which we're gonna learn for corporate programming, right? So we're gonna start with the basic one. Okay, so we'll use arithmetic operator. So that is what we're gonna do. So start with it. So let's go ahead and add arithmetic. Although you'll not see anything else here. These are not the latest one. Okay, so we'll keep adding the stuff as we write it here. Okay, I have the latest copy of what it is also. Fine. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to create another package and I'll name it as day two. Okay, and then I'm just adding my own. So I'll say arithmetic operator. So this is my UI dev module. And in that, I'm just saying arithmetic. Okay, and finish that. That will create my first class, which is empty template. But that is arithmetic operator. So what is arithmetic operator, by the way? So whenever you are using arithmetic operations like this, plus, minus, multiplication, division, modulus, okay, exponential, floor division, all those things are basically arithmetic operators. So we'll start with it. So declare two variables. We'll quickly go through it because I really think arithmetic operators are very simple. If you face any issues, just let me know. We'll stop there on that. So we're gonna stop, like we will actually start two different variables. Yeah, so I'll say item one in your cart, okay, which is of $20, and then item two something at $40, and then basically you want to do arithmetic operation. So basically, and you know that it's item one, okay, plus item two. You're gonna get arithmetic operation result for that. So this is print, and you can see total, you're gonna get that total out of it. So then this with Python run, you can okay 60. So this is just a plus symbol. You can use also basically all the operations which we saw. You can do that. So what I'll do is I'll just name that stuff in exactly the same way. So subtraction, I'll just make it as minus, and you can use minus here, right? Do we need to really go through all this? I know you guys know this stuff, right? It is like multiplication. It's just we are doing it in a programming language manner, nothing else. So that will be multiplication. We'll just take it for our example. Okay, and we'll complete this. It's not a big deal. A division, okay, and modulus, exponential and all, and floor division. See, these things doesn't, we don't use it. You see, exponential basically rest of the power. So you multiply that atom that many times. Okay, floor division is divided by that atom that many times. Okay, that's the only thing. Modulus is percentage. And then if you want to print it, you can go ahead and print those atoms as you want. Right. So this is what, this is arithmetic operator. See, arithmetic are easy. Then the next one is assignment operators. Now this is interesting. So how do you assign variables? Okay, so let's go to assignment. I didn't even run this. Okay, run it. Okay, so basically simple operators which we normally use in mathematics, right? So these are the one. Now going to assignment. Assignment is interesting. Although we have always used assignment, right? We have always used assignment for declaring variables. How do we do that? We assign it with the help of equals, right? So age equals to 21. So this is what we're going to do. So now whenever you want to assign it in a different manner. So suppose this is a normal assignment. Okay, so I'll say normal assignment. So there is interesting stuff in assignment is you can actually say age equals to equals and then plus and then 3. So now this is like age equals to age plus 3. Okay, so this equals age equals to age plus 3. Okay, so this is a shortcut of writing the stuff. So equals plus 3 is equal is something like age equals to age plus 3. Similarly, you can use anything here. So if you use subtraction, it will be age equals to age minus 3. Okay, if you use division or multiplication, it will be acted accordingly. Okay, so most commonly we'll see subtraction and multiplication in this pattern. Right, so it will be age equals to age minus 3 and it will be age equals to age multiplied by 3. Okay, so these are the assignments basically. How do we assign? So we print it. You'll see the effect of all these things in on the age variable. So what will going to happen? So first is 21 is printed, then age equals to age plus 3, so it should be 24, then minus 3 again, go back to 21 and then multiply it by 3, so that will be 63. So let's go ahead and run this and see if we can get the results accordingly. It's a problem. Can't do start expressions. Let's see if other stuff works. Ideally, you should be. Let's see. Okay, so you got. Okay, so this is an assignment. Remember that. So that's why it's like 3 and minus 3. Okay, so it was not using the earlier value of this. Okay, so that is okay. So age equals to age. Basically, age equals to, and then the value of age is considered as 0, and plus 3 and minus 3 are assigned to it. Okay, so this is bad. Okay, hold on. Did I make a mistake?